It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Just put your paws up, 'cause you were born this way, baby. My mama told me when I was young, we're all born superstars. She pulled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far.
I really don't know much.
I don't know a lot.
I really don't know anything about it. I'm not something I'm up to date on.
Actually, not a lot.
I don't know.
Junior guard Kai Allums was born a female, but at a press conference Wednesday afternoon, he told reporters about coming out as a transgender male, making him the first openly transgender Division I athlete.
Well, first of all, I just want to say, yes, I am a male on a female's team, and I want to be clear about that. I'm a transgender male, which means, like, feeling-wise, like how I feel on the inside. I feel as if I should have been born male with male parts, but I am, like, my biological sex is female, which makes me a transgender male.
Kai has decided to live as a male student and be referred to as a male. George Washington University supports Kai and his right to make this decision. Kai has informed the university that he will not begin any medical or drug protocol while a student athlete.
For Allums, coming out as transgender resulted not from outside pressure, but from a need to be himself.
I wasn't me. Like, I'm a talkative person. Like, I could talk for days, but I wouldn't talk to my teammates. I wasn't talking to my friends. I wasn't texting people. People were like, what's wrong with you? And I wasn't being me. And by saying something, I was like, okay. I was like, now I can go back to just be me and focus. And that was it.
I believe that there would have to be, as I said, a great deal of education done with teams and coaches and athletic administrators on that topic.
I mean, I feel like it was a huge benefit for us to have somebody like that. Like, obviously they're going to have natural athletic ability that's better than most girls, but you know, to have that on my team, I'd be happy with, but I wouldn't think it's fair if I'm playing against it, so I don't think it would be very fair. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Subway can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. You know, that's a good question. I think I'd be okay. You don't have to. You're just roommates. You're both just sleeping in the same room. Like, you don't have to be buddy-buddy. And even, I mean, I'm sure they'd be good people, too. So, yeah, I'd be all right with that.
You know, coaching a transgender athlete, I tend to look at people as people. I think being biracial and growing up in a My father's African-American from Holly Springs, Mississippi, and my mom is Norwegian and Swiss from small town Wisconsin. Mm-hmm. So growing up, not really seeing things based on colors allowed me to, I think, not really see things, and probably growing up in California, I'm not sure of that too. I don't really see people in these little categories.
Well, I'd love to have a 6'10", somebody that dunks. So that, in a way, wouldn't be a challenge. But I don't know the whole social and ethical and all those aspects of it. I haven't thought that much about. Obviously, there'd be maybe some issues. I really don't know. I mean, I try to accept people as who they are and what they're about.
Sometimes I feel like I want to leave this place for good.
It's a very good question. I think there would probably take, it would be an adjustment period, I would say mostly for our team, the girls in our team. I don't know how much experience they probably, or interaction they have with transgendered individuals, so having one on our team, I think there'd have to be some education that goes along with what all that entails. But I think after that education and maybe a transition period, I think just like any other teammate, they would incorporate them into our team.
Under the ground, I'll live down there without a sound. I never hear these hissing voices all the same. I'll disappear, 'cause living makes me feel ashamed.
My game changer moment is when I came out. At the time, I think I was an 11-time All-American at that point, and I ended the year with 16, and it was really hard. I was scared to death because there was nothing, you didn't hear of any trans athlete. What do you do? Like, you know, I'm still going to compete as a woman, but I want to identify as a guy. Like, it was very, very scary experience. And what changed it for me was my team and my coaches. The coaching staff and my teammates took me and no different than they did beforehand and treated me as the guy I wanted to be. They called me by the name that I had changed to. They changed my experience to be one that was just amazing. And if it wasn't for them, I mean, I don't know if I would have had the same experience. My teammates made coming out easy, and they made me comfortable to be who I am.
Well, that's the biggest issue, is the provision of a separate locker area for the person, which is one of the suggested things if they wish to have that accommodation, or if other members of the team wish to have that accommodation.
I think with any controversial issue, there's going to be opposing viewpoints, and people are going to get riled up about it. I think in this particular case, it'll be more sensitive because Americans in general tend to be on the prude side, and they don't like talking about sex. We don't like talking about kind of private matters, and the issue of transgender and transsexuality faces those right from the get-go, and so people are going to be uncomfortable. So hopefully it will be great for awareness for the transgender, transsexual community, and hopefully allow them to live more freely than they ever have before, including in the realm of sports.